Good afternoon, dear parents. I'm Priyanka Khandelwal Gupta, founder of Progressive Ed School in Pune. How do I select the right board for my child? A very common question asked by almost all the parents. So today I'm going to try to explain to you the difference between all the four major boards in India, CBSE, ICSE, Cambridge and IB. SSC, I'm going to skip it because in today's age I feel it's a little outdated, so I'm going to leave it at that. Now, if you look at all the four boards, I would differentiate them based on their learning methodology and their approach. So that way CBSE and ICSE would fall in one bracket while IB and Cambridge would fall in other bracket. I'll explain to you why. Let's start with CBSE. CBSE is governed by Indian government and it's a body called NCERT. So all the rules, regulations, policies, curriculum come from there. CBSE is the ideal board for people who have transferable jobs in India because CBSE schools are available in almost every city in the country. So transfer of the child from one school to the other becomes much easier. But then it is also based on the availability of seats in the school that you're looking for, right? CBSE focuses on India's two most favorite subjects, math and science. Yes. So if you're clear that your child is going to be studying engineering or medicine in India, then CBSE would be the right option for you because you know, the calculation, mugging up of the formula, everything happens well in CBSE, and the children can perform better in the JEE and all the other entrance exams for medicine and engineering colleges in India. ICSE is another board which would fall in the same category because it's not, again, very project-based, but the focus of ICSE is more on English language. They do have definitely other subjects, but English literature is something that's focused a lot in ICSE. So you can see a difference between a CBSE and an ICSE child in terms of his knowledge in English language. Apart from that, yes, the knowledge there would be a little more in-depth than CBSE. ICSE would be a good option for especially IT parents because transferring your child from India to any other country would be easier because ICSE is recognized in other countries as well. Now that's about CBSE and ICSE. Let's come to Cambridge and IB. Both the boards are very, very project based. Research skills are one of the major skills that these boards promote. Now there are thousands of CBSE schools in India. There are actually tens of thousands of CBSE schools in India. There are thousands of ICSE schools, but there are hundreds of IB and Cambridge. So you can understand that the focus is more on quality than on quantity in in Cambridge and IB boards. Now, the difference between Cambridge and IB is that in Cambridge, the child would dive deep into the subject that he is passionate about or that he selects right from standard 7. It's called IGCSE. Some of the ICSE schools also offer IGCSE from standard 7, so you can look at that option as well. Now here the child selects the subjects and dives deep into them and learns about the subject, does a lot of research and a lot of projects on those subjects. While in IB, there is definitely in-depth knowledge and research, but IB believes in giving more variety, more exposure to variety to children, and it focuses a lot on real world problems. So you won't be surprised you know, to see a third grade IB child or a fourth grade IB child giving very good PowerPoint presentation, which would be definitely lacking in CBSE students for sure. So Cambridge and IB are good options for parents who are very clear that their kids would want to pursue their graduation in countries apart from India, right? So preparing for their SATs, GRE, GMAT, definitely IB and Cambridge kids do much better there. It is difficult to switch from Cambridge and IB to, you know, CBSE. Like for example, if you are an IB child till say 8th grade, 9th grade, and then you decide to switch to CBSE, and then the child has to go for JEE and all these entrance exams, it becomes difficult for the child to cope up with because he has not been into the practice of learning things or memorizing things. So giving those entrance exams becomes a bit of a challenge for IB and Cambridge students. Not that their knowledge is less. They would have much better knowledge than CBSE kids, but you know, they have open book exams. They have a lot of assessments which are of different style than CBSE. So Cambridge and IB become very good options for parents who want their children to dive deep into subjects of their passion and not restrict them to just engineering MBA or CA or, you know, specific professional subjects. But if you're looking for good exposure to your children, giving them international learning, then these two boards are the ones for you. Now, talking about the curriculum is one, but the fee structure is a totally different ballgame altogether. CBSE and ICSE, you will find good schools in the range of 80,000 per annum to 1.5, 1.6 per annum. But for IB and Cambridge, the fee starts from about 1.2 and goes up every single year. There are, you know, schools who charge 10 to 15 lakhs per annum also. So you have to be clear about what your focus is, what your child's interest is, and what you can really afford. There's no point of pushing a child. You know, I personally believe a happy parent makes a happy child. So make an informed decision. See what you want your child to get. Again, board is just a medium, a methodology. A board will not decide the future of your child. It definitely gives you a way to build a future. Now, how is totally up to you to decide and select for your child. I hope this video was useful for you. I hope you had some understanding of the four boards and it'll help you make the right decision for your child. If you have any questions, you can always write a comment or go to my website and take our email ID and drop me a line. Thank you so much.